plane arises from the crash of a B-52 bomber on January 17th. The plane is reliably reported to have had four unarmed nuclear bombs aboard, three of which were recovered, but one is believed to be still missing on the seabed at a depth of 200 fathoms. There's considerable speculation that the missing object may be of a new and secret type. A United States Navy two-man midget submarine, the Alvin, is being flown in by transport plane from the States, another touch which adds to the James Bond spy thriller atmosphere which now prevails on this normally tranquil Mediterranean coast.
Professor Ambassador, did you enjoy your morning dip?
It was spectacular.
This is Radio Arcade.
Visit to Moscow, and I know the Soviet leaders pretty well, and I want to go and discuss with them, absolutely frankly, some of the big world problems, means of reducing tension between East and West, the problem of Vietnam, of course, and also to see what we can do next to discuss measures to stop the spread of nuclear weapons. Lord Chalfont, the Minister of Disarmament, will, of course, be playing a leading part in that.
You can turn me on to anything you want to, anytime at all. When I taste your lips, oh, I start to shiver. Can't control the quivering inside. Wouldn't you agree?
Walk all over you.
was it, may I ask you, that raised the issue of the pound and the economy at the last election? No other than Mr. James Harold Wilson, the little man who always says one thing and does another.
F-111, well, you Tories were going to buy the TSR-2 at £9 million a time instead of £2.5 million for the F-111. Is that saving expenditure? Now, Mr. Chairman, just to break for a moment before I turn to the other subject I want to deal with, the half-time scores are as follows. No score between Manchester City and Everton. Half time, Manchester United 0, Preston 1. But since half time, United have equalised with a goal.
I won't conceal the difficulties from you. In the past 2 days since we came into office, we have, and I can say this quite frankly, received a terrible shock. We have just seen the economic figures, and they are far worse than we expected. No doubt we will have to take many tough and perhaps unpopular measures. Heaven knows we won't like doing it, nobody would. But it is only because of the terrible mess we inherited from the last 17 months of government.
Is there any truth in any suggestion that Canterbury is going cap in hand to Rome, as it were?
Not the slightest suggestion. If by Canterbury you mean me, wherever I go, I speak, I hope, in charity, but I also speak in complete frankness. You may have noticed that in the pictures of me conversing with the Pope, I had my cap on.
Don't you see that now you've gone, and I'm left here on my own, that I have to follow you and beg you to come home? You don't have to say you love me, just be
to ask you to get up out of your seat right now. I'm going to ask that nobody leave, and everyone be quietly and reverently in prayer. I want you to get up out of your seat right now and say, I want my sin forgiven. I want Christ in my life. I want to receive him as my Lord and my Master and my Savior.
It is no secret what God can do. what he's done for others, he'll do for you.
Allah is with me, God Himself, Almighty Allah. As long as Allah is with me, the world is with me.
He's cut Cooper's left eye again, and he, just as he did before in the last fight, and Cooper's left eye is a mess, it can't go on, and that's it. It's all over. 1 minute 40 of the sixth round, and it's all over. Henry Cooper's challenge for the championship of the world has ended.
You yeah. said he was born in Manchester, so well, he ain't a proper blackie then, is he? I mean, the ones I'm talking about, they're your proper blacks, aren't they? The ones that was born in a jungle, your natives. I mean, don't tell me they're educated. Half of them are still eating each other.
Oh, devils.
Talk some ruddy nonsense, a pair of them.
Oi, 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 that's enough of that. All that swearing, I won't have it.
Look, Amy's always Lord Mary.
Yeah, well, I'm not having you Lord Mary, not in this house.
Why not?
Because it ain't bloody ladylike, that's why.
I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. I'm picking up good vibrations. She's giving me the excitations. Inches high, solid gold, and it means England are the world champions.
Morning. To the tour.
Yes.
Now, this religious controversy, I know you don't want to say too much about it, but does it worry you that it's going to boil up when you get to the States?
Well, it worries me, yes, but I hope everything will be all right in the end, as they say.
Do you think this is going to be a controversial tour like the Philippines was?
Oh, no, no. No, it's going to be fine.
What makes you say that, Paul?
Oh, it'll be fine. You watch. Yeah, it'll be great.
And we're wondering whether you're going to change the itinerary of the Beatles to avoid areas where radio stations are now burning their records and their pictures.
This is highly unlikely. I've spoken to many of the promoters this morning, and when I leave here, I have a meeting with several of the promoters who are not anxious that any of the concerts should be cancelled at all. Actually, if any of the promoters were so concerned, and it was their wish that a concert should be cancelled, I wouldn't, in fact, stand in their way.
How you feeling, all right?
Big loud hello, fellas.
John, are you sorry about what you said?
But the Beatles made a statement in all the newspapers that they're getting more better than Jesus himself, and the Ku Klux Klan, being a religious order, is going to come out here the night that they appear at the Coliseum here. I shall have about 50 men in robes, and I'll have quite a few inside the stadium.
Now, would you say that there'd probably be maybe 50,000 people here for the performance, and the 50 Klansmen are going to stop the performance?
We're known as a terror organization. I think we have...
A terror organization?
We have ways and means to stop this if this is going to be the case, yes.
Well, what ways and means?
Well, I don't want to say this, but there'll be a lot of surprises Monday night, I believe, when they get here.
You know, you can say things like that in England, and people will listen a bit more than they do in America, because in America somebody will take it up and use it completely against you, and not have many scruples about doing that. And I don't know. You know, I'm probably putting my foot in it saying that, but...
You'll be explaining the next
time. Yeah, I know. Oh, well, it's just wonderful here.
Baby's good to me, you know she's happy as can be, you know she's in the mood. I'm in love with her and I feel fine. Baby says she's mine, you know she tells me all the time, you know she's in the mood.
Up your social world. You can't come back, be the first in line. Oh yeah, you're obsolete, my baby.
I very much hope that this present campaign for quality and reliability, which is being launched today, will find a ready response in every ministry, boardroom, manager's office, drawing office, and trades union. If it doesn't, even those who couldn't care less and those who think they're all right will be defeated, because there won't be anything to care less about, and there won't be anybody who is all right.
can't weep, I can't deep, since you walked out on me. Holy cow, what you doing, child?
Holy cow, what you doing, child?
What you doing, what you doing, child?
Holy smoke, girl, it ain't no joke.
No joke.
Hey, hey, hey.
Well, I think for quite some time, and I still believe, I have agreed with those military men and those who have suggested that perhaps more of a blockade with regard to North Vietnam, the blocking of the harbor and so forth to stop the shipments of munitions in, as well as trying to intercept them on their way south, would be more effective.
More bombing?
Yes.
This short statement was agreed before Mr. Smith and his colleagues left HMS Tiger last night. The Prime Minister and Mr. Ian Smith have concluded their discussions in HMS Tiger. They have produced, without commitment on either side, a working document. They are returning to report on this to their respective colleagues. It is agreed that both sides will decide by 10 o'clock GMT on Monday, December the 5th, whether it, that is the document, is accepted in its entirety.
It is considered that the Rhodesian government would be extremely foolish were they to abandon the substance of their present constitution for the shadow of a mythical constitution yet to be evolved. And so, as you will no doubt have guessed, ladies and gentlemen, the fight goes on. Yeah.
Why can't that feeling go on endlessly?